Senator Sherwin Gachalian calls the controversial TV ad promoting charter change politically charged. Gachalian points out while he is in favor of amending the economic provisions of the 1987 Constitution, the ad is not the way to promote it. He also slams efforts to garner support for charter change through alleged bribery.
The clincher there is Ed Sapuera, no? Which is referring to the 1987 revolution, no? And I think what's important here is if I'm the one going to do the ad, it's just to focus on what is the items that we need to revise or to amend in the Constitution, rather than spin it politically. There's a lot of cloud of doubt and also corruption happening with the gathering of the signatures. That's not the essence of People's Initiative. Ang nangyari ngayon with PI, hindi na People's Initiative, Peso Initiative na eh.
As for Albay Representative Edsa Legman, the ad is another way of demonizing the Edsa People Power Revolution.
Walang substance or merit yung sinasabi doon sa ad na yan. Doon sa sinasabi nila, halos lahat na problema ng ating bansa ay ibinigay na ang kosa ang ating saligang batas. Hindi naman yan ito. Charter change ay hindi ang solusyon sa mga economic, social, and political problems ng ating bansa.
Prime movers of charter change now turning to advertising to push their agenda. And as Sherrianne Torres tells us, a paid commercial on the supposed failures of the 1987 Constitution has put the spotlight on a group advocating a people's initiative to amend the Philippine Constitution.
Pangako nila pagsulong. Pero sa
television viewers were surprised to see this paid advertisement Tuesday night showcasing the alleged failure of the 1987 Constitution to strengthen the country's education, agriculture, and economy. It also claimed the Constitution favored businessmen who abuse the system or hold a monopoly on industries while leaving people EDSA puera, which is a play on words referring to the EDSA people power and being left behind. The advertisement ended with a call to amend the 1987 Constitution. The paid ad was placed by the Ghana Atienza Avisado Law Offices, which serves as the legal counsel and supporter of the group PIRMA, or People's Initiative for Reform, Modernization, and Action.
The purpose ho nitong advertisement na napanood ho ninyo is to bring into public discussion, pwede na ba natin pag-usapan yung People's Initiative to amend the Constitution? Panahon na ba? At kung pwede na, ano ba gusto ninyong isama doon sa mga proposed na ipopropose na mga amendments?
This is not the first time for PIRMA to spearhead a People's Initiative. The group PIRMA initially hugged the news in 1997 when it attempted to amend the Constitution via People's Initiative. The group, however, failed to achieve its target to transform the current presidential form of government to parliamentary. The next group that attempted to do the same was Sigaw ng Bayan. Their petition was questioned before the Supreme Court. Sigaw ng Bayan lost. Avisado says they are supporting PIRMA as they anticipate a potential legal battle before the Supreme Court. He adds they only aim to touch the economic provision of the Constitution. Progressive group Bayan Muna questions the funding source for the paid advertisement.
Sino ang nagpondo nito? Kung public funds yung advertisement, may problema tayo. Illegal yun eh. Dahil you cannot, you know, use public funds for a private purpose.
Mm-mm.
Katulad ng People's Initiative.
Hindi po. This is a private initiative. We are a private, a small law office who represents PIRMA and other similarly minded individuals na gusto rin pong tumulong at isulong ang public consultation for People's Initiative to amend the Constitution.
At least one lawmaker wants to investigate the financing behind the advertisement. House Deputy Minority Leader and ACT Teachers Party List Representative Franz Castro says they are considering filing a House resolution to probe whether the funds came from public coffers or money from foreign interests trying to change the Philippine Constitution so they can own most of the country. Avisando, however, maintains PIRMA is still in the process of consulting people on what they think should be amended in the Constitution. He also denies the group's involvement in offering incentives in exchange for support for a people's initiative. Meanwhile, former Senate President Vicente Soto III calls PIRMA's pro-charter change advertisement untruthful and inaccurate. Soto says the problem is not the Constitution, but some of those executing it. One of the framers of the 1987 Constitution is also speaking out over the new push for charter change. Former COMELEC Commissioner Rene Sarmiento believes there's no stopping proponents from tinkering with term limits. He also cites a Supreme Court decision which ruled that major constitutional amendments cannot be done through a people's initiative.
Posible po maggalaw po ang political provisions. Kasi po kung tutusin po natin na pag-uusap-usapan po sa mga munisipyo, sa probinsya, ang pagbabago po ng term limits po. This is not insubstantial or insignificant. So para sa akin po, kahit economic provisions, kailangan po ang Constituent Assembly or Constitutional Convention. Hindi po kailangan po ang initiative, which is for minor amendments.
Albay Congressman Ed Salagman, on the other hand, sees the ad as crudely crafted with no substantial message. Attorney Aris Gana, managing partner of GAA Law Offices, explains the Ed Sapuera message was a creative concept of the ad agency to spur public discussion. But political analyst Jean Franco argues the pro-chacha ad is misleading.
Ang pinalalabas nila, parang ang pagbabago ng konstitusyon ay sagot sa lahat na major problems ng bansa. Ngunit hindi naman ito totoo. No? Pinalalabas din na very urgent ito at ang makikinabang ay yung mga maliliit na tao, no? O yung mga disadvantaged sa lipunan, no? Na hindi naman siya evidence-based kasi halimbawa kung papasok yung negosyo ng mga dayuhan, natural ma-benefit din yung mga dayuhan at mga businessmen, no? So yun yung ano ko doon, yun yung aking pag-assess sa mga ads.
A people's initiative needs the signature of 3% of the total number of voters per district and 12% of the total number of voters in the country before it could be submitted to the Commission on Elections. The COMELEC would then need to validate if the submitted signatures are authentic before calling a plebiscite. Sherian Torres, ABS-CBN News.
The Philippine poll body denying claims its 2024 budget includes funding for charter change. Albay Representative Ed Salagman earlier flagged the additional 12 billion pesos in one of the COMELEC's election budget items. But COMELEC Chairman George Garcia says that amount is part of the 17 billion pesos they requested to be restored after it was slashed from their budget proposal. Despite this, the COMELEC is not denying the possibility the 12 billion pesos can be used for a plebiscite pushing for Chacha.
Amin din natin pwede po namin gamitin yan. Nasa amin naman po ang diskresyon bilang isang constitutional body. Pero siyempre po sa kasalukuyan, nakafocus po ang COMELEC sa resumption ng ating registration. Number two, nagko-concentrate kami sa preparasyon para sa national and local election ng 2025. At number three, naghahanda na po kami para sa barangay na SK elections din ng 2025. Some to spot this point yung mga ganyan.